Hi everyone, thanks for joining me today. This is John Paul from InMotion Hosting. In this video, I'm going to show you how to compress files using 7-Zip. It's pretty straightforward, but we got a lot of traffic to this article, and we noticed that a lot of people were asking questions and just weren't sure how to do it. And so I figured we'd do this video just to kind of make it a little more clear. And we're going to start here by opening the 7-Zip program. Once it opens, you're going to want to navigate to the actual file or folder that you want to compress. In my test, I'm going to compress this important folder here, and we'll just do that, click it, and then you want to go ahead and on the top left click the Add button. You'll find when you do that that this second window pops up with some additional options, and there's a couple things you're going to want to check. The first is the archive format, which you'll see here. A lot of times by default it'll be set to 7Z, but we want to set it to zip, and you'll see the file extension changes to zip there. You could also rename the file at this time too if you wanted to. There's another thing that we're going to check next, which is the compression level. And this is basically how much it tries to compress the file or folder. This is adjustable. We had some people asking questions about this on the article. And just keep in mind that with like JPEGs and certain files like that, they're already compressed pretty well. So you're not going to be able to get too much more compression out of them. But in this case, I'll go ahead and set it to Ultra, and then we're going to click this OK button. Alright, and you'll see this is pretty quick because there's not much inside that folder. If you have a lot of files or photos or whatnot, it may take longer to actually complete the compression process. But you'll see now I have this zip file here, and at this point it's ready to go. I'm going to drag it onto my desktop. And then that way I have it now here accessible, and I can go ahead and email it to somebody or upload it to my website, whatever you need to do. And the good thing about once it's zipped is when you transfer it, it will somewhat protect the files, and there's less chances of it being corrupted during the transfer. And then once it gets up to the server, you can go ahead and unpack it, or once the person you're emailing it to downloads it, they can go ahead and unzip it. And that's it. We thank you for joining us, and this is John Paul from InMotion Hosting, and this video was how to compress files using 7-Zip. Thank you.